I learned in school that the sun, though it revolved in the solar system, in the galaxy, it did not rotate about its own axis. Is that what is mentioned in the Quran? No, that is what I learned in school. We were in 27 years back, I had learned that the sun was stationary. But Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 33, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ. It is Allah who has created the night and the day, وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ, the sun and the moon. قُلُّنْ فِي فَلَكِ يَسْبَهُونَ. Each one traveling in orbit with its own motion. That is because yasbahun means it describes the motion of a moving body. So Quran says the sun and the moon, besides revolving, it even rotates about its own axis. And today science has come to know that the sun takes approximately 25 days to complete one rotation. Who could have mentioned this in the Quran 49 years back, which we came to recently, hardly 20 years back, 30 years back? He'll give a pause. Don't wait for the answer. You can continue. Quran speaks about that the sky, Almighty God, has made a protected ceiling. Without it, life cannot exist on the face of the earth. In Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 32. Quran speaks about water cycle in several places in the Quran. In Surah Az-Zumur, chapter 39, verse number 21. In Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse 24. In Surah Hijr, chapter 15, verse 22. In Surah Mu'minun, chapter 23, verse number 18. In Surah Nur, chapter 24, verse number 40. In Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse 57. Several places, the Quran speaks about the water cycle in great detail. Who could have mentioned this 14 years back? He'll give a pause. Don't argue. Keep on continuing. Quran speaks about biology, that we have created every living thing from water. Quran speaks about botany, that we have created every plant in pairs, two and two, in sexes, male or female. In Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 53. Quran speaks about that the animals have been created from water. Surah Nur, chapter 24, verse number 54. Quran speaks about that human beings have been created from water. Surah Furqan, chapter 25, verse number 45. The Quran speaks about genetics, that it is the male fluid which is responsible for determining the sex of the child. In Surah Najm, chapter number 54. In Surah Najm, chapter 53, verse number 48-49. And Surah Qiyamah, chapter number 75, verse number 37-39. The Quran speaks about embryology. The Quran speaks about geology. The Quran speaks about oceanology. You can give a talk for us together. After every scientific sign mentioned in the Quran, ask your friend, who could have mentioned this in the Quran 14 years back? The only reply I can give you is the creator, the manufacturer, the maker, the inventor. This creator, this manufacturer, this inventor, we Muslims call as Allah, we call him God. So today, science is not eliminating God, it is eliminating models of God. La ilaha illallah. That's the reason a famous philosopher by the name of Francis Bacon said, little knowledge of science makes you an atheist, but in-depth knowledge of science brings you closer to Almighty God. So you can ask your friend to see my video cassette, Is the Quran God's Word? And Quran Modern Science, in which there are various other proofs talking about the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hope that answers the question.
We would request non-Muslim brothers and sisters, if you're curious why this book, Al-Quran, it should be read compared to so many other readings you may have, which may be more engrossing, more interesting, more thrilling for you, feel free. This is your opportunity to ask. We have Dr. Zakir Naik on this side, and this is your session. I am here to help you clarify and help you get a proper answer, inshallah. Maybe we have the next question from the sister's side.
Assalamu alaikum, brother.
Any non-Muslim sister?
This question is on behalf of a non-Muslim friend named Dipti.
Okay.
She's working in a call center.
Okay. Excuse me. If any non-Muslim brother or sisters here who has some reservations on coming in front on the mic, we would allow them to put a question through your friend. Or if there are question slips available in the aisles with our volunteers, feel free to write your questions. I would request the volunteers to kindly have slips presented and shown in your hand so they can get the slips from you. Put your question on the slip, have it sent down to me on the stage, and inshallah, the more interesting one from them, we would put it forward to Dr. Zakir. But it's more preferable you ask on the mic. So that it's not that I am playing around with the slip or juggling with them and putting the more easy questions in front. Yes, sister.
The whole question is it compulsory for me to accept Islam to read the Quran? Can I read the Quran without accepting Islam?
This is a good question. That is it compulsory for me to accept Islam to read the Quran, or can I read the Quran without accepting Islam? As I mentioned in my talk, that the Quran was revealed as a guidance to the whole of humanity. It's not necessary that you have to be a Muslim to read the Quran. But inshallah, if you read the Quran with an open mind, an unbiased mind, and an open heart, inshallah, inshallah, after reading the Quran, inshallah, she'll accept Islam. That is the reason Yusuf Islam, in an interview, he said that it is good that I read the Quran before meeting the Muslims. He read the Quran, he accepted Islam. If he had met the Muslim before in the Quran, maybe he wouldn't have accepted Islam. So the Quran is the best example. It is the guidance for the whole of humanity. And you can very well read the translation of the Quran in the language she understands the best. And if she has any query, she's most welcome to ask on the email or to our foundation at www.irf.net. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you, sir.
May I clarify for those who didn't know, Brother Yusuf Islam is the same person, Cat Stevens, the very famous, one of the leading pop singers, British pop singers. Yes, brother, anyone here? Any Muslim, any brother there? On the second mic? Any sister has any question on behalf of any non-Muslim? If there are no questions on the slips or on any of the mics.
This is a question from a student, Aparna. She's in the audience today, and she would like to know, why is Friday given more importance?
This is the question, that why is Friday given more importance? And the beloved Prophet said, it is like a weekly Eid. Like a weekly Eid. Like how the Christians, they have Sunday, the Jews had Saturday. So for the Muslims to be different, that's the reason the Prophet chose Friday. And there are various hadith which mentions the benefit even of Friday. The Sahih hadith mentioning that the Noah's Ark came and it got the land when there was a flood on a Friday. And various benefits. But in the Islamic context, it is the weekly important day in which we have the congregation of Salah. And the congregation Salah, it is more important. Normally we pray 5 times a day, but once a week we offer the Jummah Salah, which is a bigger gathering. It's like a weekly Eid, and it's compulsory that we should pray in that gathering, so that, and in that Jummah Salah, like we had today in the afternoon, the Imam gives a qudbah, he gives a speech and gives guidance, to the weekly guidance to the Muslims, what is the requirement. He may talk about the local affairs, he may talk about things which are important and convey the message. So Friday basically is a weekly Eid, or a weekly main day of the Muslims. Hope that's the question.
Thank you.
Yes, brother.